And soccer sets a roll into the postseason. We'll look back at the last week of the regular season with head coach Ken Lola. I'm Sean Moth. Great to see you again. The Cards have a UC Irvine matchup last Wednesday at home, and then on the road to face Cincinnati for one that didn't have a lot of implications, or with maybe the exception of RPI, which is now at 8, by the way, waiting for the next one to come out. But let's go back to Irvine. This you don't want to call it a trap game, but middle of the week, you know, studies are kind of getting to the guys, and it's a team you could easily look past. Unfortunately, we got a little late magic from Dylan Maris to avoid that.
It's a game that will test your focus.
Yeah.
There's no question about it, because we had just wrapped up the Red Division, at least the number one seed. It's an out-of-conference game and a team that was struggling record-wise. So for us, it was more a test of our ability to stay tuned in and stay focused. And it was a rough start. I don't think we started as well as we could, but I thought the second half we got it going. And again, a couple of good goals by Daniel Keller gets his first off a restart. And
yeah,
like you said, Dylan finished a very good goal late.
So I think the 88th minute for that game winner, the Cards thought that wasn't impressive enough. So on Saturday, they made things even more interesting at Cincinnati. What it does is it seals you guys as the number one team in the Big East in terms of your points, puts you as the one seed, gives you the bye. The Cards will host on Saturday at 7 o'clock against the winner of a Cincinnati-Marquette matchup that will be played in Milwaukee. But at Cincinnati, we discussed how tough it was to play. You just told me off camera that teams had scored 3 goals on them at their place all year. So really, I know Hilton's had a tough year, but he's played really well at home.
Yeah, they have. They've done very well at home. They've made it very difficult for opponents to score on them. And for us to get the game winner late was a great result for us. And again, I think, you know, what also is impressive is we got the shutout there. You know,
yeah,
we didn't give up a goal and kept ourselves in the game and did well to get the result.
When Coach says late, it was all but a buzzer beater, which is something you really don't see a lot in soccer. Have you ever seen? You've had a lot of late heroics since you've been here. Even that Final Four run that season, there were a lot of late goals. But have you ever seen a goal scored that late in a game?
I haven't been a part of one where it was the last kick.
Yeah.
It was on that. Brock Ranger's toe that he got to the ball was the last touch of the game, and the game stopped after that. It was a great celebration, and I know a little frustration for Cincinnati because
yeah,
they had put a lot into it, but again, I give our guys a lot of credit because on a day where, you know, we tested our depth a little bit and didn't play necessarily our best soccer, we put ourselves in a position at the end of the game to win it.
And it seems like, too, that we talk about building a culture of winning. It seems like having scored late before, there's a high level of belief, and maybe that leads your will to not stop until that final buzzer, because you've had so many opportunities to score late goals like the 2 this week.
For sure, and a part of that is also the depth we have, that
yep,
guys that have come in and helped us not only at the end of the game but in the second half, of giving some minutes off to some guys and still maintaining a high tempo to what we do. It allows, you know, guys like Dylan to get back on late. You
sure
know, it allows guys that attacking wise to come on it a little bit fresh at the end, and which allows us to you know, be in a position to win games.
Anybody specifically stand out in either of these 2 matches this week?
I think Paolo continues to be a guy that does well. You know, especially in games that matter the most, Paolo is stepping up and being at his best. There's no
sure
question about it. And defensively, I give our guys a lot of credit. You know, Irvine got one against us, but really, we've done a good job of shutting teams down and limiting opportunities. So defensively, I think we've been very good. And, you know, Greg Cochran has played in a lot of different spots for us this year. And against Cincinnati, we played him deep in the midfield, and his work rate was very good, and he
yeah
continues to give us a great effort.
Outstanding. The Cards, the one seed out of the Red Division. The Blue Division should be the Black and Blue Division. There are 4 teams there that have really been fighting tooth and nail. In fact, Marquette is the 4 seed out of that division, but they're ranked as high as 3 in one of the polls on RPI of 11. They'll be hosting Cincinnati. Kind of an unusual situation in terms of you guys scouting. I mean, you pretty much have the Cincinnati scouting report. Now I'm sure you'll be focusing pretty heavily on Marquette, but it could provide an intriguing matchup either way. A very good Marquette team coming here Saturday, or a ticked off Cincinnati team that's going to want to come in here to Cardinal Park. Either way, it should be fun.
Yeah, and either way, it's at home,
yes,
which is a huge advantage. We like playing at home and encourage all the fans that at the football game, as well as all the soccer fans that may not be there, to come out and support us, because it makes such a difference in our results. So having them at home, Marquette would be a great matchup from an RPI standpoint of helping us. And just the same, seeing Cincinnati again, a very good opponent, obviously. Either way, it's the one game that will allow us then to get to the Final Four at Red Bull, and that's huge from a standpoint of winning not only the conference tournament, but also putting yourself in the best position possible for the NCAA tournament.
No question. The Cards will do it Saturday night. We'd love to have you at Cardinal Park. Should be fun, and that matchup between Marquette and Cincinnati is on Halloween, in case you want to watch and see who the Cards will be facing. We'll be sure to talk about it next week. Best of luck to you and the team, Ken.
Thanks so much, Sean.
For Ken Lowell, I'm Sean Moth. Thanks for watching. We'll talk next week right here on Cards.